From KPRC2, this is Houston Newsmakers with Khambrel Marshall.
Good morning and welcome to Houston Newsmakers with my special guest, Dr. Ruth Simmons, formerly the president of Prairie View A&M University, who in what seemed like warp speed has new roles and responsibilities for two major universities. More on that in a little bit. But first, Prairie View A&M, you were talked out of retirement. Presidencies at Brown and Smith College, you broke the color barrier at both those institutions. What was the attraction to Prairie View to begin with? And as you finish, what accomplishments do you look back on with most pride?
Oh, my goodness. Well, first of all, I'm a native Texan. And when I went onto the Prairie View campus, I saw in those students the person I was when I was going to school here at Wheatley High School and aspiring to college. And that really tugged at my heartstrings. And I wanted to be of help to them. Mm-hmm. In terms of what we've accomplished, there's been so much during this six-year period that I'm proud of. I'm proud of the fact that we have increased financial aid resources available to students. I'm proud of the investments we've made in our faculty and in scholarship and research. That has elevated us to a Research 2 university, mm-hmm. which is a big step for us. There are only 11 HBCUs who are in the Research 2 space. I'm very proud of the hard work that our faculty have done during a tough period of COVID, keeping our students going, upping the graduation rate, all of that. I'm just enormously grateful to everybody at Prairie View who works so hard to support our students.
So the time for you to step away, you decide you're going to step away. You plan to do that June 1st, but you did so earlier because you said in a letter to the university community, you could not be president in name only. What did you mean by that?
Well, I'm an old hand at this, having led Smith and been president of Brown. And so I'm generally recognized across the country as one of the best college presidents in the country. The system approached me and asked me to stop making appointments. And I had 4 months to go. And I thought, well, that's very odd. Why should I do that? I want to put as much time as I can in helping the university and making the way for the new president to be successful. When I sought to learn what was going on, why is it you don't want me to be president anymore? I got no response. Mm. I wrote a letter to the chancellor asking for clarification and saying, I intend to be a president in full for as long as I'm here. Mm-hmm. And if I cannot be there, that I'll step down. And he gave me no answer at all.
Not even after that?
Not even after that. Instead, the response I got was, speak to the public relations person about the text of your resignation. So the only response I got was a public relations response, which is, okay, that's fine, but we want to make sure that when you tell the story of your stepping down, we control it.
So that seems like a slap after all that you've done at the university. From the outside looking in, that seemed to be a backhand.
Well, it seemed that way to me, and I'm not a very demanding person. In terms of things that I want for myself. Mm-hmm. I'm very demanding in terms of what I want for my students and right. for my campus. And I don't want my campus to be denigrated in any way, okay? I don't want it to be treated as if it doesn't have the capacity to prosper on its own. Mm-hmm. And that's what it felt like to me.
So in a couple of sentences in your letter stood out for me. I want to get more follow-up on that. You said, no enduring good can arise from subservience to low standards and expectations. Further down, when you referred to continued support for HBCUs, you wrote, we must not be held hostage to how others choose to see us or treat us, but instead continue to chart our own path, demonstrating the pride, commitment, and integrity that defines us.
Absolutely. Absolutely. That's the way I felt. I wrote that from my heart.
We could do a college course lecture on just those two sentences, specifically those messages. Those two sentences said a lot about HBCU's history and the way
yes.
HBCUs have been treated
of
historically.
Course. Of course. And of course, Prairie View is part of a system, and a system is governed by a Board of Regents and a chancellor. And there's quite a bit of distance between what the regents understand about Prairie View and what Prairie View needs to do. And so if you're in a governance system that doesn't get you as an institution, it's a struggle. Mm. And so they want to set the road for Prairie View without understanding what Prairie View is. We have to assert what our history is, what we need to be, how we can best serve our students, and that has to be valued by the Board of Regents and the Chancellor. Otherwise, we are no more than lackeys to a huge system.
What's it going to take to change that? You mean, your stepping down is not really going to help change that dynamic about the way that the regents, you say, are treating Prairie View.
Well, I think, Khambrel, you know that governance is very important in the country, and it's important for institutions too. We have a governance system that does not represent us. And so one thing that could be done is to change the Board of Regents and the structure of the system so that there's more agency for the universities within the system, particularly when you have one that is so different from every other institution historically and otherwise in the system. I think it's good for Prairie View to be in the Texas A&M system. If Texas A&M values Prairie View and treats it with respect and gives it representation, then it's fine.
Mm-hmm. But right now
it needs some help, and I'm available to advise them about how to do that, because I advise boards all over the country.
Well, I'm good you're making yourself available for that. Well, you know, you didn't waste any time getting other things to do. You stepped away. You're now.
I wasn't looking for it.
You're a distinguished fellow at Rice University and senior advisor to the president of Harvard on engagement with HBCUs. Talk about those roles.
Well, of course, Harvard had asked me to relocate to Harvard to assist with a new initiative that they have to help HBCUs. And I thought about it and thought, I mean, how can I leave Texas? Mm. I mean, this is home. I came back here after years away. Mm. I don't want to leave Texas, and I don't want to leave Houston. So Rice understood my dilemma and said, look, Rice can offer you a place to work and a home because we have things that we'd like for you to do also. So between Harvard and Rice, they worked out that I could do the advisor position for Harvard from my position at Rice. So everybody's happy.
Everybody's happy, including me, who is the president of the fan club of Ruth Simmons fan club. So
thank you. Hey.